anecdote that happened between Professor Kasturi and Swami. As we all know, Bhagwan used to make several trips to all over the country, various parts of this country. One of the trips that he made was to the holy land of Varanasi, North India. So Professor Kasturi was one of those people who was selected, and he was told, "Kasturi, get ready, I'm taking you to Varanasi with me." And Professor Kasturi was so thrilled. Now, for all Hindus, you know, Varanasi is one of the holiest of places. You know, it is, it's like a lifetime ambition to go to Varanasi, you know, to be able to have a dip in the holy Ganges, have the darshan of Lord Shiva, visit the temples. It's a very holy land, and every Hindu would like to go there. So Professor Kasturi was very excited. He said, "In this holy land of Varanasi, I must get my mantra from the Lord today." So he planned. So he wanted to get a mantra for his self-spiritual improvement in Varanasi from Swami. So he selected the muhurtam, he selected the tithi, everything, he was ready. And on that day, early in the morning, he even went and had a shivering dip in the Ganges. He didn't have his food. Now at this point, a small deviation. Some of my brothers who would have lived with Swami will know that when we decide, "I am going to do this," you can rest assured that Swami is going to put a brake on it. He'll find a way. The reason is very simple. In fact, I believe some of the time, some of the devotees asked Swami and said, "When we want to do something interesting and something good, why is it, Swami, that we face every kind of obstacle?" And then Swami drew an analogy and he said, "See, when you plant a fruit-giving tree, no fruit-giving tree will come up and grow just like that. Every fruit-giving tree takes a long time to grow. It is your responsibility to guard it against every kind of animals, thieves, and other things, protect it. You have to struggle a little bit, all kind of obstacles you have to overcome, and only then one day you will see the tree bloom and you will get the fruits." So manchi sankalpam, that means a good thought, when it crosses your mind, God will test you in every way. He will test you in every way basically to see how strong we are, how determined we are to continue with our pursuit. Swami, being the Jagat Guru, being our loving mother and father, our guru, everything, he is definitely not going to leave such a chance. So when Professor Kasturi had a shivering dip of bath, he said, "I'm going to fast the whole day. I'm going to wait till Swami is going to give me the mantra, and then I'm going to start my prayers. Until then, I'm going to fast." Now begins the drama. Breakfast came and Swami asked for Professor Kasturi to be made sit next to him. Now this is a tricky situation. How would you escape? Everybody is eating, Swami is eating, Professor Kasturi can't eat. Because he has decided, "I'm going to fast." So Swami observed from the corner of his eye, didn't tell anything. So Professor Kasturi fasted. Lunchtime came, still no mantra appeared. Lunchtime also, Swami was sitting, Professor Kasturi was again sitting next to Swami. Still no mantra. Again, Swami saw that Professor Kasturi was not eating anything, no comments. Dinner time finally came, and Professor Kasturi was fasting still, and this time he was sitting next to Swami, and this time Swami decided to ask, "What, Kasturi, you are not eating anything?" That's why I called it a drama, because you know, the way he asks you, it's very easy to assume, "Ha, Swami doesn't know anything, I have to explain everything to him." It's very easy to make that mistake. We are guilty of that several times. So Professor Kasturi was already distraught, so he was sobbing and he blurted out, "Swami, mantra." Then Swami said, "What mantra?" He said, "Swami, mantra, this is the holy land of Varanasi, I have been praying to you to give me the mantra. You have still not given me the mantra." And then Swami looked at him, smiled, and he said, "Kasturi, what is the purpose of a mantra?" Then Professor Kasturi said, "Swami, to get closer to God." Then Swami looked down. You know, Swami's thigh was on Kasturi sir's thigh. They were sitting shoulder to each other. And then Swami asked Kasturi, "How much closer do you want to get?"